WTP, we have recently launched a new policy called Digital University, which directs the university to use new technology such as cloud technology in classroom for lecturers, students, and also in the workplace for non-academic staff. Recently, at the beginning of the year, we introduced to our staff Google Applications, which is a cloud system, and a very new technology to our staff. The cloud system allows us to work anytime, anywhere, and it reduces our budget spending on papers and other office equipment. Now I would like to thank our guest speaker for arranging the course for IMUTP. We are very appreciative. I also would like to thank you, Education New Zealand and New Zealand Embassy in Thailand, and Knowledge Plus for making this happen. Finally, thank all the attendees for joining the workshop today. Thank you.
As I was saying earlier, the pathways, so we have certificate to diploma, we have bachelor degree, we have graduate diploma, and we have postgrad diploma ready to master's. For international students, we have period entry to bachelor year one, year two, or year three, a graduate diploma, and also at master's diploma. I will not go further with this elaboration because our concentration is on cloud computing security, and we actually don't have enough time. 3 hours is not enough time to talk about security. I do admit that. So what I thought that we don't need to talk a lot about what is the impact, because that is what is going to be our realization by the end of today's workshop. This is the one headline is supporting us. I have taken this from one of the New Zealand newspapers, many ones. So, what I argue is cloud computing itself is not a technology. It is a concept of computing approach where we use remote resources, and this cloud computing is an encapsulating wrapper for any kind of computing. So you can use any kind of computing. Whenever you are using someone else's computer or network infrastructure or even the servers, which is somewhere else, and you access those through network or internet, that is called cloud computing. Okay? This is the website, not our website anyway. This is a US-based organization. This is the domain name. You can download a lot of these images ready-made for education and research purpose, and you can use it freely. You can use it for teaching or even use for anything. Digital Corporation, if you go there, you will be able to download some of these files. Just to show you, if you go through this, you will see that the image files they have are a screen dump of mobile phones, a screen dump of the image file of computers, and so on. What I did, I have downloaded some of them. In this computer, in my virtual computer, and I put them in this directory.
And the one thing,
yes. So investigator can find out what file was deleted.
ก็คนที่ทำการตรวจสอบก็จะรู้ว่าไฟล์ไหนโดนลบไปแล้วก็เวลาแฮกเกอร์จะแฮกเขาจะหา open port ในระบบ
nmap by using nmap you can find out a remote system, their operating systems, which ports are open, and a lot more information. White hat hacking. You become a thief to understand how a thief works.
ก็เพื่อคือต้องการเป็นโจรก่อนถึงจะรู้ว่าโจรมันทำขโมยของแน่เลย
Because if you know how to become a thief, you are the best person to know how a thief is going to come to your house and steal something.
ก็ถ้าเราเป็นโจรเราก็จะรู้ว่าโจรมันจะเข้ามาทางไหนในบ้านเรา
And at the beginning I told you, cybercrime costs us $600 billion a year.
ก็อาจารย์ก็ได้บอกไปตอนต้นแล้วว่าไซเบอร์คราฟต์เนี่ยอาชญากรรมทางไซเบอร์เนี่ยมันทำให้เราสูญเสียเงินไปเป็นจำนวนมากถึง600 ล้านเหรียญ
So the world people really needs white hat hackers so that we can save ourselves from cyber criminals
เราจะช่วยชีวิตตัวเองได้เราต้องมาเป็น white hat hacking